All right, hello guys, and welcome to the first season. Well, the fourth season, I must say. The first race in Italy. I am here with my good friend, Sir Prachigram. I think that's how you say it, Prachigram.
It's like Magikarp backwards.
Yeah. So, how you doing, man?
I'm fine. I'm really looking forward to today. It's my first one that comes, and well, I've been following but I'm really eager to see what's gonna happen today. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good. I'm just really excited to see what's going to unfold today. And just excited to see the first race of the season being at the Temple of Speed.
Yeah, well, interesting you say that. It's we've come back to the Temple of Speed. We've been here on the last race of the second season this year, and we had some of the same drivers at that race as well, which was actually won by Julian, who dominated last season. So it should be interesting to see if he can keep the flow going and win again today.
Yeah, I really think just how this season will unfold with some new drivers in here, the likes of Luca coming back. We haven't seen him since, well, he made a little cameo appearance as a reserve driver, but we haven't actually seen him fully in the race since season two as a full-time driver. And we also have Toma joining Julian in McLaren. We also have Bats joining Stinner in the Red Bull. And we also have Baraka joining Luca in the AlphaTauri. And we must say that we do have another new face in IFR Risa.
Yeah, he just came in last second today, and it's all right. And Williams had to make some moves to gain some drivers, and they've got one. And
So I
it's
was. Oh,
sorry.
now you go, you go.
Oh, whereas I've seen him driving in TUF2. Never seen him drive in TUF1. At least not that I can remember. But I know he has been fast, so interested to see if he can keep up with the pace in this in TUF1.
Oh yeah, definitely. As I was about to say, I was on board with Pricey on his because he was the first person out, but he has invalidated his lap, so I'm not sure who the next person to cross the line will be. It might be Luca, as he already sets a 118.7. But then
But
Risa,
Risa, oh,
yeah.
he's going really fast.
Wow, he's gone faster than Julian and Luca. But yeah,
Hello,
we'll
Risa.
yeah. He's done well, but I think let's have a look at the tires. So yeah, all of them are on softs apart from Boseman and the reserve driver in today, which is Pricey. Let's see who's potentially going to be crossing the line. It looks like it's going to be Boseman next. He
On the mediums.
does a 119.8. That's not bad from him.
But it's
I think
just on the line.
the next person closest is going to be Dreamzy as he goes round Parabolica. Quite a good line. And if he can maximize this, maybe he could maximize it more to the edge of the right edge of the track there, but it does get a 120.2.
Well, I'm really interested to see how Dreamzy is going to do this season, because he just stepped over to a racing wheel last season, and he's really getting the hang of it. But you
Oh
might
yeah.
see some minor mistakes, and I'm really happy or eager to see how he is going to evolve.
Do see Toma set a 119.4? Of course, this is his first race in TUF1, so getting a solid lap, putting him 10th at the moment. With still, how many is that? That is 7 drivers still to set a lap. We do have Dobby and Bats currently on out laps. Well, they're currently on their fast laps, I must say, but Bats already going faster than Stinner. Even if it's only 0.035 of a second, he's stepping up to the plate with Stinner. He's showing, look, I might be the rookie, but I've still got the pace.
Yeah. Well, it's really good lap.
So yeah, let's hop on board with Dobby as he's just heading to Parabolica now. He breaks in, gets nice and tight, and slowly gets towards the outside and then cuts straight back in towards the inside. He does hug the inside and he goes fifth fastest with a 1:18.8. And I think there's 3 more drivers on their fast laps.
Being
Schoen, Boogeyman and Baraka. And I think it's going to be Boogeyman who's going to be closest to setting their first lap.
We just entered third sector. Oh, it just goes wide. Might be validated. I'm not sure. Behind him. Little bit of step up. Yeah, Boogeyman goes in.
Yeah, I think. Yeah, he did. Get an invalidation there, but I think the next person is Baraka. He hugs the inside just like everyone else, and he goes fifth fastest.
Right. Oh. We've got some fast new ones.
He's got some serious pace after seeing him even in the reserve spots. I've seen his pace and he is electric.
Why does Schoen goes back in? Not a set of lap time at this moment.
So we do have Julian on a fast lap at the moment, just going through the first chicane, going through the Curva Grande.
Okay.
So let's just see how he takes this next chicane and then the two Lesmos. He does set a purple first sector. He takes his chicane lovely. Let's see how he takes first Lesmo. Breaking early on the acceleration, perfect. The second one, it's a little bit longer and he gets it slightly towards the edge, but he did keep it in. Now, before the race, this is where we were talking about lots of people are caught out. He does ride a curve round and that's just the perfect line through there. You're not going to get any more perfect. He does try to pick up a little bit of a toe on Young Breezy, just going down the straight as he gets on the power towards the outside, hugs the inside all the way around, cuts it a little bit. By 0.004 seconds, he gets pole.
It's a close one, and Riss is at the end of his lap as well.
Can he go any faster? I don't think he can.
Nope. he was on his outlap. I might have misjudged.
But Boogeyman has been disqualified. I'm not sure what that would be for, but he's been disqualified from the session.
Alright, I'll take a incident. Boogeyman. He drove in the wrong direction.
So we do have Pricey. Bit of contact between Pricey and Eden.
Yeah.
But I don't think they won't get penalties for that, I'm sure.
No, but it's weird because Pricey is on his fast lap and Eden just came out of
no I think Pricey there had just set his fast lap, so this is his in lap.
Okay. Oh. Yeah, you're right.
And
you're
I think this is Eden's out lap,
this is
I think.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. But looking at the gap at the moment, it seems like there's a real gap forming from between Eden and Pricey. That's really the cutoff at the moment.
Yeah, there are like 3 tenths between them.
Yeah, and then just looking at a gap from Pricey to Toma, it is only, 0.139 of a second. It's just nearly 1.5 tenths.
So anyone can take a...
Definitely.
And I think someone can even go a bit faster and shave off some more. Because it is within reach. 3 tenths is a lot, but... if you're just daring and taking a little bit more risk, it might pay off.
Oh yeah. Just looking at like the gaps at the moment... I did see Bats, he did go a little bit under the radar there. He has set a 19.004. And we do also see Dobby jump Baraka on that lap, going for an 18.427.
As Kuhn is just closing his lap, setting his first time. And he's coming in at 8th place.
Yeah, that's not a bad lap at all, an 18.8. That's a very solid lap from him.
Yeah. Which leaves only Santero without a lap time.
Yeah, Santero and Boogeyman, obviously, he did disqualify for driving in the wrong direction, which sometimes can be a bit broken, especially when you're trying to reverse onto the track. But again, just the gap between Luca, Risa, and Julian.
It's nothing.
It's just 0.23 seconds between first and third.
Yeah.
We might have another contender here. We might have someone who's going to be competition for Julian and Luca.
Well, yeah. It wouldn't surprise me. Because Rizzo was not a level when he raced in TUF2 when I saw him there, but for him to come in like this, unannounced at the last day, well, it's a bit of a shocker.
We did see on the first. I'm just on board with Julian at the moment. He did invalidate at the first chicane, so I think maybe he's going to be going round again, just. Or maybe he's just going around and seeing what lap he would have set.
Because he was 0.05 being under his own lap time.
But I think maybe he's just putting it in lean a little bit, putting it in no ERS and just trying to, he's warming up his tyres a bit, he's just getting ready for another lap, I'm pretty sure. But there's 4 minutes left in the session. We have currently 8 drivers on track. He's coming in. So that makes 7 drivers on track, with Santero the only person not to set a time. I say let's hop on board with Santero. He's just starting his lap. So let's see if he can string one together and propel himself up into the high places. As he can maybe cut the corner a bit there in the first part, but all in all it's an okay attempt at the first chicane, as he does go around Curva Grande now. He does hug the inside, which will give you a tighter line. He does the second chicane well. He goes into the first Lesmo, and brakes, hugs the inside, accelerates towards the outside. That's a good corner there. And let's see if he does the same, accelerates to the outside, takes a little bit of curve. That looks good to me.
It looks like a good rep.
Might be around.
He did get a purple sector 2 there, Santero. Yeah. Or maybe that's just... That might be to the people around him.
I'm not sure.
I think when you're quite... I think... It may be a purple sector to the people around you, but it goes around Parabolica. Hugs the inside. Could have been a little bit tighter there, but 14th so far.
Well, while you were following Santero, Fnatic just jumped up from 14 to 11th place. So, it's a bit better.
It's a bit better.
Gold Andy might start as boss level right now, because he entered that one really slow. With a 126, yeah, this is his first lap.
Yeah, so... Let's see how he gets on with this lap. So, obviously he could cut that first part a little bit more, but he does carry his speed well through there. Again, through Curve Grande, hugging the inside of the corner, drifting out a little bit, and then cutting to the outside so he can get a bigger angle, and he does invalidate that lap, so I think he will probably end up going round again and setting another lap, although he is 10th. And the only people around him who could maybe get ahead of him are Bats and Pricey, who are both on out laps at the moment. So, if you're Andy in this situation, do you go for another one, or do you risk it and just go back in? Because the tyres at the moment may well be, like, they might be too far gone that if you set a fast lap for the race, they will be not good.
I don't know what I would do. I think because I believe the race is not won, I'm qualifying, it might be a better decision if one or two people are going to overtake you, that it might be better to start outside of that top 10 and be able to choose your own strategy, use fresh tires. I'm not sure.
Yeah, but whilst we were doing about that, Luca set a 117.8.
Ooh, that's another level.
And then Hamrez jumped into second place with a 118.108. So, this is really heating up at the moment. It's really heating up for Julian, Hamrez, and Risa. I would find it really surprising if... the only person I can realistically see jumping Luca now is Julian.
Well, Julian and Reese are coming.
Oh, he does. Oh, the times. Julian gets ahead of Hamrez by 0.002 seconds.
Well, Reese
and then Reese. I think this is the first race we are going to see that Julian isn't starting on the front row of the grid, apart from the end of last season.
Dobby wins another place as well, which makes qualifying. These are the final standings as everyone finished their qualifying. It was really a surprising end for me.
Yeah.
I didn't really think that that there was that much time to win, but man. 117.8.
Just quickly, we do have in the chat, we have the Bats fan club in here. Don't think I haven't noticed you guys. We have the Bats fan club in here.
Alright. Welcome, fan club.
So we have Luca and Risa on the front row. Both of them getting sub-18s. It's just like, it is so close.
Yeah.
so close right at the top, like even separating second to fifth, it's like 0.2 of a second.
Well, if this sets the tone for how the race is going to be, then we're going to see a lot of action on track, or we might see a lot of action on track, because the top four is really fast, and I think there's some racing skill in there as well. So.
Oh yeah, definitely. But just looking at like this, this is the first time in a long time that I've seen, obviously apart from the last two races of last season,
yeah,
where Julian gave himself a bit of a challenge. Like the qualifying sessions they took seriously, this is the first time in a while that I've seen Julian not be in the top row, like be in the front row.
Bit of a shocker.
But what are the kind of strategies that you'd see around here, around Monza?
So the soft tires, they last for around 11 laps on Monza.
So yeah, we can see here on the on the graphic that they last around 9, 10, 11 laps, maybe even longer if there's a safety car. But if there's a safety car in the first few laps, typically I'd say after lap 5 or 6 people will swap to either mediums or hards.
Yeah. Well, if you're going to mediums, then you really have to keep yourself from
Yeah, and I think maybe it's more of a, do you think a 2-stop could work? If it does, if you are put into a situation where you put on to mediums early?
I think, yeah, if something happens and you hit around lap 5, 6, like you said, and there might be a safety car or a virtual safety car, it might be beneficial for you to make a 2-stop on your tires.
Yeah.
Then you don't have to, then you don't have to take into consideration to get a bit of the throttle and just go what Monza is made for and go at max speed.
Yeah, and I think obviously this track is all about pure pace, and I think going to the hard tires, it can work, but they're just such a slow tire.
Yeah, they are. I think the hard tire.
So if we just look. Oh, sorry, you go. I cut in.
It might even cost you a lot of penalties on this track, because it's really hard to take the chicanes on full speed with these hard tires. That's where you can gain the most.
Yeah. So, obviously, just looking at the tires that everyone's on, obviously the top 10 are on softs, and then it's mixed bag from the second half of the grid. We have F1 Attic, Toma, Bats, Santero, Boseman, and Boogeyman on mediums, and then Pricey, Young Breezy, Squicknick, and Dreamsy all on the softs. So, a few drivers going for the alternate strat here.
Yeah. Well, interestingly, the 11 to 13, so those three are going to race each other for a longer time.
I'm not sure what's happening here.
On the grid,
everyone's on the grid, but we're just waiting.
Do we have to call someone? The FIA? Are the lights broken?
I think we may have to get onto the phone to someone.
I'm not sure what's going on right now. It's kind of like when they when they finish the race one lap early.
Oh, yeah.
It's a mechanical issue, which...
Yeah, I don't know. It's broken. I think we may host. I think Sean is the host, so we'll have to wait and see what he says about this. We may have to do. We may have to restart the lobby.
Yeah.
On my screen, it says we're on lap 2.
Yeah, mine as well, lap 2 of 27, but yeah, that's been broken for some time, but...
So, right. Oh, and I've got an error.